A circular portion of diameter r is cut out from a uniform circular disk of mass m and radius r as shown in figure. Calculate the moment of inertia of the remaining portion of the disk about an axis passing through the center O of the disk and perpendicular to its plane. Here it is a given circular disk. From this circular portion is removed. Then for the remaining, this red colored one, what is the moment of inertia about an axis passing through center and perpendicular to its plane? Now, for the entire disk without cutting, the moment of inertia if I take, which is equal to mr square by 2. Moment of inertia of the circular disk about an axis passing through center and perpendicular to its surface. Now, if I imagine m is the mass of the circular portion removed, so what is the value of this mass? We know that in the case of two-dimensional object, mass is directly proportional to the radius. So small m by capital M, if I assume this is r by 2, this is r, so nothing but 1 by 4. So small m is equal to capital M by 4. Now for the removed mass, if I take only the small part, the radius of this part is r by 2, because diameter is r means radius is r by 2. Now axis is touching the end. Here the axis is there perpendicular to the plane and touching this end. We are assuming this axis, this is our O. So about this axis, if I call moment of inertia is some I1, then I1 is equal to Ig plus mr square. Here Ig is the moment of inertia about this axis, this is my Ig axis. So it becomes small m into radius is r by 2 whole square by 2, because mr square by 2 is the moment of inertia of the circular disk. This is also a circular disk whose mass is small m and radius is r by 2, plus small m into the distance between these two parallel axes, r by 2. So if I take m into r by 2 whole square common, the remaining 1 by 2 plus 1. So this is mr square by 4 into 3 by 2. That is 3 by 8 mr square. But already we know small m is nothing but capital M by 4. Therefore, our I1 becomes 3 by 8 capital M by 4 into r square. That is 3 by 8 into 4 mr square, or 3 by 32 mr square. Now we need the moment of inertia for the remaining. So remaining now becomes the moment of inertia of the remaining portion, if I call it as I2, which is equal to I minus I1. So what is our I1? I mr square by 2 minus 3 by 32 mr square. So take mr square by 2 common, becomes 1 minus 3 by 16. So this is mr square by 2 into 13 by 16, or it is 13 by 36, sorry, 13 by 32 mr square. This is the moment of inertia of the remaining portion. So first calculate the moment of inertia of the full disk, then calculate the moment of inertia of the removed part about the same axis O. Axis is same in both the cases. For the removed part, what is the moment of inertia? I1, since the axis is not passing through center, Ig plus mr square, small m, mass of the removed portion, and the distance between the center of the removed portion and O, r by 2. So I minus I1 gives the remaining portion moment of inertia.